It's okay, Whiskers. I'm almost there. Oh, you silly, climbing up here. You know you're afraid of heights.
I found them, Uncle Rudy. Hello?
You asked for it. Time to release the awesome power of the vengeance.
See? Everything's gonna be just...
Krista!
What? Woohoo! Gotcha.
You're in my light.
Whiskers?
Ah, he's tasting me.
It's her, and she's not tasting you. She's smelling you. Just stay still, and I'll get her off.
Krista!
Oh, will you turn that thing off?
That thing? The Benjin is a highly sophisticated information and communication device. I rigged it with a terabyte memory chip, an amplifier, projector...
And it plays great hold music.
Uncle Rudy?
And the flash. Well, sort of. Can you give me a hand there, Benji?
Sure.
Hi, kids. Can you see me?
Oops. My bad.
Ah, yeah. There we are. That's much better. Namaste, my young friends. Namaste. That's hello and goodbye in Nepali.
You're in Nepal?
We're in Nepal. At least we will be on Friday. I'll be meeting you at our base camp.
Whoa, we're going to the mountains?
Himalayan. And I ain't just describing Marco in a hammock. You get it? Himalayan?
So, we're really going to Nepal?
You know of a better place to search for the abominable snowman?
How about one of Marco's mythology books? Because they aren't real.
They're two. They're called Yeti.
Yeti are about as real as Shangri-La, or the Loch Ness Monster.
Your parents thought Yeti were very real. Aside from Guatemala, where they adopted Marco, Nepal was their favorite place to explore.
I read in their travel journal that they thought they saw a Yeti, but Mom's camera froze and they couldn't get a picture. They wanted to go back one day, but...
So we can go instead and finish where they started.
Oh, yeah. That sounds like a brilliant idea.
I knew you'd think so. I've already booked your flights to Kathmandu. From there, you'll hop a small plane with my friend and Sherpa guide, Hassan. The Sherpa are native to Nepal. Many of them are outstanding mountaineers and trekkers. You'll have all your permits and supplies.
And he'll take us to the Yeti?
Well, if we're lucky. That's why I need you to bring your parents' Nepal travel journal with you. It's filled with valuable notes, so guard it with your lives.
We will.
We what?
Signing off now, kids. Namaste.
Namaste.
Gesundheit. Oh, remember to bring warm clothes. Or when I meet you at base camp, we'll all be colder than a penguin's butt. Later.
Wait. We can't just run off to Nepal.
Why not? Mom and Dad would have.
But you heard him. Guard the journal with your lives. This could be dangerous.
He said penguin's butt.
Wow, this is great. And we didn't have to ride in any junk piles like that thing over there.
Namaste. Welcome to Kathmandu. You are Krista Benjamin and Marco North, yes?
Yes. Are you Passan?
Passan, yes. It means Friday, the day I was born. Old Sherpa custom.
Aw, is he yours? What's his name?
Name? He's Monkey. I call him... Monkey?
He looks like a Bucky to me.
Check it out. He likes it. Hi, Bucky.
Gee, bummer you don't have this effect on boys.
Yeah, drop it, penguin butt.
Penguin butt.
Ready to fly?
In this? No way. I'd kiss that monkey before I got on a plane like this. This is not funny. I can't believe we're actually on this plane.
It's the only way to get to Uncle Rudy. And Hassan says it's perfectly safe.
Oh, yes. If flight is smooth, very safe.
Whoa!
What if the flight's not so smooth?
Then we could have problems.
Okay, that's it. We're talking to the pilot.
I knew it. We're gonna plummet. I hate plummeting.
We're not plummeting. We're just plummeting.
Oh, look. It's like the mountain itself is rushing forward to greet us.
The pilot says we may have a fuel leak. He's shut down the power to one engine.
Fuel leak as in we'll crash? I knew this hunk of junk wasn't safe.
No, he said we should have enough fuel to land safely. We can either stay and hope for the best or parachute out, but we have to choose now.
Are you kidding?
Remind me never to listen to you again.
What? We're still in the air.
Barely.
I can see our landing strip.
We're gonna be okay!
I would prepare for a most invigorating landing.
We've landed.
Oh, right. I knew that.
So, who is ready for lunch?
Hassan!
Namaste, Nima. This is Nima, your uncle's pilot. Nima, this
Rudy is in trouble.
What happened? Is he okay?
I don't know. Yesterday, we got a radio transmission of a Yeti sighting. I warned him a storm was coming, but he rushed off into the mountains to see for himself. I've tried to reach him over the radio, but I get nothing back.
Oh no, Uncle Rudy!
You don't think he's...
No. Rudyard is a wise explorer. He is safe. We find him. Come. The storm has erased most footprints, but I find these. Maybe your uncle's.
Let's see if they match my model in the Benjin.
You have a model of Uncle Rudy's feet? You are so weird.
Perfect match. Pretty impressive for a weirdo, right, Krista? Right, Krista?
Cut it out. Loud noises can cause avalanches.
It's just a myth. But the reality is that Krista owes someone an apology, and that someone is...
The Benjin!
Avalanche! Run!
Pull the cords on your jackets!
What?
I said, pull the cord on your... Krista! Marco! I tricked out some of our gear before we left, just in case.
Pretty cool. Or a weirdo.
You're welcome.
You guys, what about Basong?
Dig! It's tent fabric. We're in the wrong place.
Wait, I rigged a sonar attachment to the Benjin. I can find it. Here, hurry!
I see him! No! Hassan!
Hey, someone get this monkey off my back!
I found something on the bench. Check it out. Look, Uncle Rudy's tent. Made from the same red nylon we found in the snow. That means we're on the right track.
Speaking of tracks...
Yuck.
Not yuck, yak.
Yak?
Yak. Herd must belong to the owner of the house. People here speak no English. I ask if they seen your uncle.
Hi,
sweet things.
Sweet? Watch the way they look at us. I think they're plotting something.
Oh, really? Like a yak attack?
Gross!
She has not seen your uncle, but says she would be happy to let us stay the night.
Yeah, she doesn't look happy. I think we better pass.
Tell me you're kidding. We're tired. It'll be dark soon. She's offering us a place.
Oh, I wish we had more clues. It'll be dark soon, and Uncle Rudy could be anywhere. Oh, we don't even know if we're getting warm.
Getting warm? That's it.
What's it gonna do? Make us hot chocolate?
No, it's my newest invention. Benji's launchable aerial heat seeker. It'll take an aerial picture and highlight anything over 86.2 degrees. I call it the Blaz.
Or you could call it Blame.
See? Here we are. And look, there's another shape not too far off. Let's go. By the way, the Benji prefers a handwritten apology in triplicate.
Whoa, what in the world are these?
Those are called seracs. They're bits of glaciers that are always moving. They're most likely to fall just after the hottest part of the day.
How do you know that?
Journal, page 105.
Just after the hottest part of the day? That would be now, right?
Yeah, but look how sturdy they are. I'm sure it's fine.
Marco! Krista!
There he is! It's Uncle Rudy!
Hang on! Everyone okay?
Whoa. Excellent work, everybody. Excellent. You stopped a disaster cold.
Yes, and saving you was icicle on the cake, right?
Well put, my old friend. Well put. Icicle. Well, now, who's the simian?
What? You don't recognize your own nephew, Benji? The monkey's Bucky. He's one of us now.
Well, then, I'll be a monkey's uncle. I'm a monkey's uncle.
That's weird. Something just popped up on the Benjin's radar. It's a temple, and it's only about a mile away. We should go. I bet they'll put us up for the night.
No way. Mom and Dad's journal maps all the buildings in the area, and there's no temple.
So, maybe it's...
I am honored to be dining with you. Hudson and Amelia were exceptional individuals.
How do you know our parents?
I was a great admirer of your parents' adventurous spirit.
I still can't get over how weird it is. I mean, when this temple popped up on the Benjin, we didn't even know if it was real. Turns out you're not only real, but you know Uncle Rudy and our parents. I don't know, it's just strange. It's like we were meant to find you or something.
Yeah, right.
Something the matter, Benj?
Yeah, I mean, it's great that we're here and we're safe and all, but nobody seems to care that it never should have happened.
What do you mean?
You promised to meet us at your base camp. You knew we were coming, but you ran off anyway, and we had to go save you. Do you have any idea how close we came to getting killed out there?
Well, but you didn't, right?
No thanks to you. We're kids. We shouldn't even be here. We should be home doing normal kids stuff.
But you had a great adventure. How many kids can say that?
Who cares? You're just like Mom and Dad. If they'd cared more about us and less about their stupid adventures, maybe they'd be alive too.
Benji?
Nah, it's okay. Benjamin, your parents loved you. Loved all of you very much. They would have done anything for you kids.
Sometimes things happen for reasons we cannot understand. There are many secrets in the universe, and we will never know all of them.
Big comfort. Thanks.
But you have all proven yourself great adventurers, worthy of learning one particular secret I know. If you so choose.
Secret? What secret? I love secrets. Tell me!
The secret of the Yeti. But I must warn you, once you know it, your lives will never be the same. Please stand with me. When you are ready, step upon the new path your life is about to take. Apparently, the others were ready for their journey, but you are not. There is fear and anger in you where there should be love.
Where'd you get that? A Tibetan fortune cookie?
Ah, you have been hurt, and you protect yourself by staying safe, surrounding yourself with inventions that will never fail you.
How do you know all this about me? And how did your temple just appear on the Benjin? Who are you?
You have a choice to make, Benjamin. A life of complete safety in which you will be free to open for yourself many doors of endless possibility. But you will be alone. Or you can choose a life of high risk and endless adventure, shared with your loved ones. But you will need to risk getting hurt again. Benjamin, your fate is in your own hands. Choose your path.
No, I need to speak with Uncle Rudy. Uncle Rudy, I don't get it. Why do you defend Mom and Dad? They left us.
They never meant to, Benj. Their death was an accident.
But it didn't have to happen. Normal parents who care about their kids are careful. They don't go running all over the globe getting into danger.
Your folks loved life, Benjamin. They refused to waste even one second of it. And they also loved you kids and wanted you to greet every day with a sense of adventure. Look what a good job they did. They turned out three of the bravest, spunkiest, most intrepid explorers I've ever met.
I guess.
I know you're mad at them for leaving, but running away from everything they gave you, that just hurts yourself.
I just miss them, that's all.
I know you do. I know. So do I.
Well, we're lucky we still have you, Uncle Rudy.
Thank you.
Welcome to Shangri-La.
Where?
Shangri-La. The mythical Garden of Paradise. That's the secret, isn't it? Yeti are the gatekeepers of Shangri-La.
Correct, my boy. And they only allow entry to those they deem worthy.
It's so beautiful here. How long can we stay?
As long as we want. So it seems to me we have quite an adventure ahead of us. Shall we begin?
Yeah. Let's have an adventure.